So the class we took was cooperative as a tool for decolonization. So I was attracted to this course because I'm a global studies major, and I'm like, how can I connect what I'm studying with co-ops, maybe like a future and a career, bringing my community organizing to it. So I just kind of came in trying to get self-interest for myself. But I came out really like thinking of the bigger picture of co-ops, because as you know, we're an island among frats. And you can very be like think that we're the only ones out there, and then when you come to NASCO, you're surrounded by different co-ops and different ideologies of like what a co-op should be and just how we can use the concept of a co-op to really change the world, because that's something that just affects our community, but it can affect the world.
Definitely. I came to this class because I enjoyed the title Decolonization, and like we talk a little bit about colonization and decolonization, how colonization is like pretty much destroying culture and their way of life and their land base and their resources and exploiting them. So the reason I came to live in Minnesota, and Minnesota has a long history of colonization and genocide of indigenous people, so I thought it maybe had something to do with that. But it was a little different. It definitely talked about colonization in terms of like a lot of like pretty much the way of our humanity's way of life in terms of both race, like class, gender, etc. Yeah.
Who was the speaker?
It was a girl from Berkeley. She just set it up because she's Latina, and she's really interested in how the co-op movement, we think of it as being like hipsters and like intentional communities, but these minority groups such as the African American cooperative movement, which has roots like way back in history, they did it because they needed to survive, and how there's now been a shift of like intentional communities coming together, and it actually created a heated debate among the people that were there. It was kind of just freestyle, you could just talk back and forth, it was like a dialogue. And one person was talking about how, what did they say? They were talking
about discussions and teaching
about,
people?
No, that one girl, remember? She raised her hand.
Was she queer?
Yes.
Yeah, you said something like, I get sick of telling people.
But the discussion got pretty heated at times.
Yeah, okay, so it kind of felt like they were attacking Caucasians, saying like, because there are minorities in the discussion, and it was really cool hearing their perspective on how like, we came into this because it was a cheap housing, and like, this is the way to live like, more, like, within our community, and like, create like, more of like, empowerment for our ethnic group. And kind of felt like they were attacking Caucasians because at one point somebody was like, it's not the job of us minorities to teach you guys how to live cooperatively. And she's like, I'm too tired at the end of the day. I have too much to do to be like, this is how we should live cooperatively. And it's something that Caucasians have shifted away from more to like this capitalist, like individualistic, like, I'm not gonna clean the bathrooms and I don't care. Like, I'll do it because I have to do 5 hours, not because, like, I'm trying to sustain this community. And I think that, like, really made me mad because that's the whole point of an intentional community. You're coming together to learn from each other. Don't tell me that you're not learning something from us being in your house, too. And, like, who defines what is Caucasian? We are all minorities in some way or another. Like, you could be queer, you could be, like, from a low-income family. Like, I don't know. That really riled me up, and I was like, that's the whole point of an intentional community, coming together and learning from each other.
I'm going to take, like, probably the opposite side of the spectrum, and me being a white, privileged male, I think the people of color and quote-unquote minorities have every right to be pissed off.
Well, I agree with you. But it just kind of felt very, like, oh, I can't learn anything from you either.
Oh, yeah, it should be a mutual dialogue, but I think there also needs to be an understanding that people of color and who have been colonialized are often, like, socially traumatized because of those situations. Mm-hmm. And often have to exert a lot more stress and energy into their daily life than more privileged people have to. And what I thought was pretty interesting, too, about how different people are going into co-ops for different reasons, and how when you Jilla brought up the chore thing and how some people do a chore because they have to, but other people do a chore because they want to, because they want to have the input on the house and make the house like a beautiful thing. I'm going to give a shout out to Patrick here, because he does, like, the way he makes beans and rice and spends that extra time and, like, kicks ass on his dish beach chore, he does that because, like, he appreciates what the house has to offer and is, like, putting that into there. So it's, like, the different way that co-ops are nowadays and how they're being more capitalized or more commodified and being, like, a white upper middle class thing to do. Yeah.
Do you guys think that the separations drawn in the class were too generalized? Like between, it sounds like class or race.
What do you mean that generalized? I don't know.
Like simplified?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, this is what I thought was very interesting, because after the girl made that comment, an Asian girl raised her hand and was like, you know what, like, we can all learn from each other, and, like, that's the whole point of coming together to live with each other. And I think she really showed that the issue is more complex than just drawing the lines, like, minority versus, like, majority, and then talking about the whole concept of, like, co-op used to just, like, a skill to survive rather than, like, a tool to, like, learn and empower individuals. So, yeah, I think they did, it started out really simplified, but then by having the dialogue instead of, like, somebody lecturing at us, like, made it more complex. And, like, the whole point of, like, why she wanted the workshop is just to, like, start this dialogue, so we start thinking about how we can better our co-ops, like, as a community, but also, like, how can we bring that information out into, like, our neighborhood and, like, where we live. Especially, like, for us, like, we're the only one, like, really, for students. Mm-hmm. Minneapolis, rather than like here where they have multiple homes where they can just have like a queer home or like, you know, a non-abuse home, substance abuse home. Mm. So, and they can, you can just like pick and choose, but like we kind of should incorporate everything. I don't know.
Yeah. One thing I want to add in that I didn't say before is around what a way that if we were as a co-op wanted to approach an issue like this, it would not be to treat it as a numbers game, which is something that people talk about, like, oh, we've got, like, 10% of the people in our co-op are black, yeah. But that's just like saying, oh, yeah, Obama's the president, we have a black president, there goes racism, we're doing good. It goes a lot more than just, like, trying to get people of color into the co-op, or it goes, yeah, a lot deeper. I don't exactly know how you can get a little further than that, but just, like, get away from, like, the tokenism of it.
What she said was that, well, somebody raised their hand afterwards to that comment and was like, a way we can escape that is by knowing that we each are bringing our own histories to the co-op and that it will affect the house, and not just to like necessarily view somebody as like, oh, we need a black person in our house so we can be more diverse, but like, what histories do we bring and how does that affect like our house and who does it attract? Then that could like open it up to be more diverse. I think that's what she was trying to say.
Mm-hmm.
But that's it. That's all we like really learned.
Yeah. I've got one more thing too that she said at the end. I really didn't go into it. But solidarity, not charity.
Oh shit.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Charlie, for doing this.